Hello, hello.
Oh.
This is Parallax.
And Breaker Head Mash.
We're commentating Rocket Rumble 20, the $200 pod bonus special. We've been well underway in top 8 for so far, but this is Winter Center, Cobalt versus Doe. And Doe had a pretty dang good upset against Shelter. And Winter Quarter is just a round to go. Pretty crazy stuff in that set. But
yeah.
Good on him for taking that set.
Yeah. Yeah. Meanwhile, lots of jumps, so. I don't know.
Tends to happen with Mithra when you're too far away.
Yep.
You don't have your jump and your resource. That's like a dead Mithra.
That is really like, the only resource that she has. Is that jump. Meanwhile, Rob over here has Gyro for days and Mithra for days.
Yeah. And he's one of the biggest backers.
I mean, both of these characters have big backers.
Oh, they're massive. Bad spot for Joe right now, but Cobalt playing with neutral there with Cobb is pretty oppressive right now, but still hanging on at 100%, 113 now.
Still has a jump.
130 plus. But,
that
drift in. Cobalt taking game one. Pretty comfortably. Joe had his moments that game, but, thinking that he can have a chance to bring it back this next game.
Yep. And I mean, this is best of five, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, absolutely doable.
Stop the battle. Mithra. Rob.
I didn't see the counter pick. Do you know what they picked?
Nope. I didn't even see the stage counter pick.
Okay, run it back. Okay,
yeah.
I can see that.
Knowing Doe, it usually
runs. It's a refresh set, you know, it's. Seeing where he stands against the character and how he's feeling, it's a good stage comeback. Always the best, one of the most consistent in this game. But, sitting 36%, you know, not too bad. Starting out with the interactions, but yeah, when you're on the platform, you're in a tight spot against Rob. Anything.
Yep.
Up tilt, up air.
Gyro,
yeah. Such good skill pressure. Baiting out an option. Foresight, though. Ooh,
yeah.
Clutch.
Foresight is. Probably Doe's ticket to winning this.
Yeah.
That and also just big hitboxes from Pyra.
Oh, exactly.
Big hitboxes generally hit big bodies a lot easier.
Mm-hmm. Especially with one of the biggest bullies like Rob.
Ooh. I like the extension on the dare with a gyro.
Oh, the up is coming out of nowhere, though. That was stupid.
Nice
play, but jumping at the worst possible time.
Yeah.
Doe.
I feel like the uppy was supposed to be reversed, but
I was thinking so too, just to catch him lagging a little bit. Sneak 40%, he's getting combo across the stage. Here.
That is Rob.
Yeah. Need some time to reset, but Cobalt's just kind of going off a little bit. He's,
yeah.
You know, like, don't needing an answer for sure right now. I'm trying to answer back with that down air, but nothing on top of it.
He got the fish in again. And
no way that kill off the top.
Rage.
I mean, yeah, but Pyro's a heavy character.
Not that heavy.
Ooh, this K. Nope, that's it.
Damn. Yeah, no jump.
Too low.
And that's a semi-solid two-stock to Cobalt.
JB3.
No, was it a JB3?
Yeah.
What? No, he was at 141.
Yeah, but he didn't lose a stock.
Yeah, that's not a JB3. JB3 is when you end at two stocks with 0%.
Impromptu JB3.
That's not how that works.
Mulligan.
It's just a face stock.
It's one in my book. Okay, switch to Incineroar. Okay,
I can see this. Just, you know, being able to armor Gyro.
Exactly.
Maybe. I actually don't know.
I call back to the set at Combo Breaker Game 1, Wadi versus Animal Kingdom, where Animal Kingdom got away with a lot of, you know, different conversions that Wadi was trying to pick up with Rob. Like, you know, yeah, you can set your armor through. A lot lot of his moves. He can have a top, he can revenge top.
Yeah, I mean, especially revenging top. Oh
yeah,
yeah.
Exactly. I'm trying to inadvertently, like, close the pressure that's coming from Rob.
And then also just reverse it, obviously.
Exactly.
With the revenge. That,
no,
I mean, he is heavy, though.
Good timing from Joe.
It did get rid of the revenge, though.
Yeah.
Which, I mean, yeah, taking a combo like that.
But I mean, instant regardless, it's just a still an even game in my book.
Oh, especially if he can get some revenge box.
Yeah. Two conversions and he's just gonna be. But Joe just getting caught up and much faster to it.
To be fair, having Rage as Incineroar is not the worst idea. Ooh.
He can find that up smash though, but he's gonna go down throw. Yep, down
yeah,
throw.
Yeah. I mean, yeah.
Sitting at 45%. Which wants almost a cobalt. But
ooh, that was a good parry.
That was a great parry. You need an answer right now. This is close.
Yeah, I think learning how to parry Rob Nair is like really huge for the matchup, isn't it?
Oh yeah, you can really get yourself out of some bad situations on ledge or in neutral. You can time that perfectly.
Yeah.
Just have a really safe option to get out of parry with, or grab, or
yeah, literally anything.
Yeah.
Just like that. Yeah.
Rob, 50% on Doe, I mean, it's not a whole
definitely
lot of deficit, but...
I mean, with revenge, though...
Oh, yeah. Anyone's using that game up in 1.5. With top and hand 2, I mean, I usually fancy to put, like, if I ever have top and hand 2, throw it
up. I mean, that is a very good option.
It's super easy just to, like, throw it away, like, not do anything with it.
There's actually... There was one set that I had against the Rob where my method of winning, or the game I won, I actually ended up just grabbing top and then just holding onto it and waiting for him to try and charge it again, and then just throwing it at him. He's like, you were looking for this? Here it is.
This isn't impossible, but it's
I mean, free revenge from that top. Like, you just set the top and forgot about it. He's like, hey, that's free revenge, but this is a Rob combo. And that.
Not quite. Ooh, that back air though.
He's still on it.
Yep. Okay, that's a Cobalt taking a 3-0 over Doe.
Rob.
Rob agenda. That is the matchup.
It is indeed.
Alright, so up next, I think we are gonna have.